एंगुलर वेलोसिटी। நம்ம லீனியர் மோஷன்ல பார்த்துருக்கோம். லீனியர் மோஷன் தான் வென் எ பாடி மூவிங் இன் ஒன் டைரக்ஷன், தட் இஸ் லீனியர் மோஷன். லீனியர் மோஷன்ல லீனியர் டிஸ்பிளேஸ்மெண்ட், லீனியர் வெலாசிட்டி அண்ட் லீனியர் ஆக்சலரேஷன் படிச்சிருக்கோம். சேம் வே பாடி ரொட்டேட் ஆகிற போது, வென் பாடி இஸ் ரொட்டேட்டிங், ரொட்டேட்டிங் அபவுட் அன் ஆக்சிஸ், அபவுட் அன் ஆக்சிஸ் ரொட்டேட் ஆகிற போது, சப்போஸ் இனிஷியலி அட் டி இஸ் ஈக்குவல் டு ஜீரோ, the body, a particle is here, and the distance from the axis, the particle is at a distance r from the axis of rotation. After time t is equal to t, the particle, say initially p irukku, inga p dash la irukku, inge vandirukku, so this is also r, and it is making an angular displacement of say d theta in a small time dt. ஸோ பார்ட்டிக்கல் என்ன பண்ணுது, இப்படி பார்த்தோம்னா இந்த டிஸ்கை வச்சு இப்படி பார்த்தோம்னா பார்ட்டிக்கல் இஸ் ரொட்டேட்டிங் அபவுட் திஸ் ஆக்சிஸ், அபவுட் திஸ் ஆக்சிஸ் இட் இஸ் ரொட்டேட்டிங், இது கிளாக் வைஸ் ஆர் ஆன்டி கிளாக் வைஸ். அதை நம்ம எப்படி வச்சு பார்த்தோம்னா பார்ட்டிக்கல் இனிஷியலி இங்கே இருக்குது, ஆஃப்டர் சம் டைம் இந்த பார்ட்டிக்கல் இங்கே வருது. ஸோ திஸ் இஸ் த ஆங்குலர் டிஸ்பிளேஸ்மெண்ட், டிஸ்பிளேஸ்மெண்ட் மேட் பை த பார்ட்டிக்கல் இன் ஆங்கிள். ஸோ வி கேன் சே ஆங்குலர் டிஸ்பிளேஸ்மெண்ட், angular velocity and angular acceleration. We describe the motion, the body at motion nama edha edha vachi solluva, angular displacement, angular velocity and angular acceleration. So theta t varudhu, idhu vandha the particle vandu linear displacement epdi panirukku, linear displacement la ds, this is in a angular displacement d theta, in a time dt the particle p comes from P to P dash. Trigonometry la vera padichirukom aarambathila, this into this is equal to this, that is ds is equal to v theta into r. This angle multiplied the distance of the particle with respect to the axis of rotation is equal to the linear displacement, the ds is the linear displacement. In vector form we can write ds is equal to d theta into r vector. Dividing by time, this equation dividing by time, ds by dt is equal to d theta by dt into r vector. Ds by dt, what is ds? Rate of change of linear displacement is equal to linear velocity is equal to, linear velocity is equal to rate of change of, what is omega? Omega is equal to angular velocity is equal to rate of change of angular displacement. Here velocity is equal to rate of change of linear displacement. So this we can write omega into r. This is the relation between linear velocity and angular velocity, where r is the distance of the particle undergoing rotational motion from the axis. So idha nama pannaona v idha vector formula adha vector formula adha cross product of two vectors idoda magnitude appra idoda magnitude appra rendudukulla angle sin of theta into n cap. So modulus of v enna varum omega r theta enna varum theta enna varum theta will come as 90 degree. First we have to see the direction of theta will come as sin theta nochko. Okay, what is the direction of angle? Since angular velocity is a vector, it will have a direction. So what is its direction? Adha direction enna namba paapom eppadi paaka mudiyum. See, body is rotating like this, this is the distance r, this is axis, in particle particle ko axis ko le distance vandu r, r namma omega cross r pandrom. So it means velocity will be omega cross r is a cross product of these two vector is this one. It means this vector will be perpendicular to the plane of omega vector and r vector. Vectorly namu padichirpom, if two vectors are cross producted, then the resultant vector will be perpendicular to this vector and this vector, and plane containing these two vectors. If omega inda pakkam irukudha, r inda pakkam irukudha, rendu perpendicular ulla direction la irukum. perpendicular radius in the book or in the book. So now let us see, when the body is undergoing anti-clockwise movement. Remember, anti-clockwise movement, omega is positive. It means omega is positive, and omega is positive in upward direction along the axis. Linear, the angular velocity is always along the axis, that is omega. If it is clockwise direction motion, the angular velocity will be along the axis downward. You have to remember, clockwise means it is omega downward, anticlockwise means omega upward. This may be counter. So this is the direction. It means what? If the body is rotating in counterclockwise, anticlockwise, it rotates like this. So it will be in the up direction. Angular velocity will be up. If the body is rotating like this in clockwise direction, the angular momentum is along the axis downward. This is the direction of angular velocity. Now, so this is the direction of angular velocity, this is the direction of R, this is the direction of linear velocity. Linear velocity, at any point, if the body is undergoing a circular, a clockwise or anti-clockwise, at any point, this point, you want to know the linear velocity. Linear velocity will be tangent if it is rotating like this. R is omega. Omega is along the axis upward. Upward is anti-clockwise movement. This is R vector. R vector omega, because B is equal to omega cross R. It means it will be either perpendicular to this vector and this vector. It means towards me or against me. Since omega to R, if you are coming, omega to R, if you use this rule, omega to R, you come this way. Omega to R, because omega cross R means omega to R. It means cut over Liam Bakar. It means the tangential velocity will be tangentially. This is the linear velocity. If linear velocity in the Bakar, then force in the Bakar, because acceleration in the Bakar. Acceleration in the Bakar, then force in the Bakar. Because velocity is equal to acceleration is equal to dv by dt. V in the direction and the direction of acceleration. Same way, force is equal to mass into acceleration. Acceleration in the direction and the direction of force. So this is R vector. So omega, this is omega. This is omega, either this way, and this is R. Omega cross R. You see, vector which is equal to tangential velocity. Tangential velocity will be omega and R cut over, it will be in this direction. This is, otherwise we can simply say the linear velocity will be tangential at any point is will be tangential in the point that linear velocity can be, if this is the rotation. So omega v is equal to omega into R, and omega R direction number, but omega is R is 90 degree. So v is equal to omega r sine 90 into n cap. This is the modulus r. V is equal to omega r into sine 90 is equal to 1. This is the magnitude of linear velocity. So V is equal to r omega. Ipdi ezhudalam, but omega 1 n varum, omega 1 is or particle inge irukku, inge irundhu inge povum, innor particle inge irundhu inge povum, ellathukku angular displacement, angular displacement d theta. It means angular velocity for all the particle rotating in circular motion is same. It means omega is equal to omega 1 is equal to omega 2 is equal to, you can say omega of every particle remains constant for a given speed of rotation. But V depends upon R1 into omega V1, V2 is equal to R2 into omega. See, for the particle 1, this is R1 distance. For particle 2, this is distance R2. It means since R1 is less than R2, is less than R3, we can call it as R3 and for so on. So, it means R1. So, R1 into omega less than R1, R2 into omega is less than R3 into omega. That is R1 omega, omega is equal to V1 is less than V2 is less than V3, because the velocity, linear velocity depends upon the distance of the particle from the axis of rotation. That varies from particle to particle, but omega is same, so velocity will be different, and more the distance from the axis of the particle, more is the velocity. So linear velocity vary out, angular velocity vary out for a given speed of rotation for your body. Now, it means we can come to the conclusion, V1 is not equal to V2, and V is proportional to R, and omega is equal to constant for a given rotation, right? Next numerical. If omega is equal to t square plus 4, find theta at t is equal to 2 second. If theta initially at t is equal to 0 is equal to 0. It means the initial condition is given. Initial condition is given. Theta is equal to 0 at t is equal to 0. Final, you have to find out theta final is equal to what at t is equal to 2 second. It means 0 second le 0 displacement irukudhu. At 2 seconds le this much of angular displacement with respect to x-axis. So, as it is, angular displacement, angular velocity, angular acceleration. So, on integrating, so omega kodutirukapla, omega is equal to t square plus 4. Omega is equal to t square plus 4. Appa, what is omega? Omega is equal to rate of change of angular displacement. So, we can get angular displacement d theta is equal to omega into dt, or d theta is equal to omega. What is omega? Omega is equal to t square plus 4 into dt. On integrating, what on integrating, we have to integrate this one also. What is theta? Theta initially is equal to 0, and finally theta, what is the final? Final, after 2 seconds, what is the angular displacement? That is the limit, 0 less 2 seconds. Time and other 0 seconds less to 2 seconds. The equation karta ni limits simply bolna, initial time 0 la initial limits, time is equal to 2 seconds, final limit. Initial angular displacement is equal to 0. What is final displacement with this condition when omega is given? So, d theta by this and this get cancelled. Theta into theta, you can call it theta final by 0. This is equal to t cube. Pannumna, either power increase pannu, t 2 plus 1, 3 divided by the same power plus integration of 4 into dt. 4 into dt, integration of dt is equal to t, 4 into t, 0 to 2. In case of integration, varlana, mathematics tools for physics, you upload pandra, adha paathukka, adha detail da illa, integration eppadi pandra, differentiation eppadi pandra, logarithm eppadi irukkudhu, trigonometry eppadi irukkudhu, illa detail la solli irukka, so adha paathu therinjinga. So, first idoda initial theta final, idhukku badhila potta minus 0 is equal to, first idha potta t cube is 8, 8 by 3 plus 4 into 2, 8 minus, this is 0, 0. So, this is theta final is equal to 32 by 3 radians per second. That is angular displacement. What is asking? Also calculate number of revolution made in 2 seconds. 2 seconds la evlo revolution, 2 seconds la evlo revolution pannirukanga. See, one revolution pannunda it is making a 360 degree. 360 degree means 2 pi radian, because pi radian is equal to 180 degree, 2 pi radian is equal to 360 degree. So in 2 pi, one full revolution, in one revolution, it is making 2 pi radian, one revolution. Or 1 radian, evlo revolution, 1 by 2 pi equal to 1, 2 pi revolution. 2 pi revolution. Appa radian theta, idu theta, theta is equal to 1 radian. This is 1 by 2 pi is revolution it is making. Appa theta is equal to 32 by 3 radians, 32 by 3 radians arundha. Ethana revolution avo. So theta radians evlo avo. Theta into 1 by 2 pi revolution. So here theta is equal to 32 by 3. So revolution made in theta 32 by 3 radian is equal to theta into 1 by 2 pi, or theta is equal to 32 by 3 into 1 by 2 pi is equal to 16 by 3 pi revolution is made in 2 seconds. Numericals. If theta is equal to 2t square plus 4t plus 1, find the average and instant angular velocity from 2 second to 4 second. So time is given, initial time is equal to 2 seconds, t final is equal to 4 second, and we have to find out angular velocity, instant and average. Angular velocity instant and angular velocity average. Angular velocity average. Angular velocity average is given by delta theta by delta t. So angular velocity is given by change in angular displacement by time. So we have to find out delta, where delta theta is equal to theta final minus theta initial. Theta phi, since theta is given by 2t square plus 4t plus 1. So theta at final means at 4 seconds. 4 seconds is equal to 2 into 4 square plus 4 square plus 4 into 4 plus 1. So 16, 32 plus 16, which is equal to 49. Theta initial at 2 seconds is equal to 2 into t square, 2 whole square plus 4 into 2 plus 1. This is equal to 4 plus 8, 16, it's equal to 17. So we can say omega average is equal to theta final minus theta initial by final minus theta initial. Theta final is at 4 second is equal to 49, and this is 17 by 4 minus 2. This comes up to, so angular velocity average comes out to be 16. So angular velocity is, this is angular velocity unit is, this is theta radian, this is time. So radian per second. Now we have to calculate omega instantaneous. Omega instantaneous means omega, if you want to find out omega instantaneous, you have to integrate, differentiate the angular displacement. A rate of change of angular displacement gives the instantaneous. See, so W instantaneous is equal to, but what is theta? D by dt into 2t square plus 4t plus 1. 2t square is equal to 2t square, 2 into 2 into t to the power 2 into 2 into t to the power 1 plus 4 into t to the power 0, that is 4t plus 4 is equal to 4t plus 4, 40 plus 4. This is a angular velocity, instant angular velocity. So if you want to find out angular velocity instant at initial time t is equal to 2 second. Initially, what is angular velocity for t is equal to 2 in this expression? 4 into 2 plus 4, 8 plus 4, 12 angular radian per second. Now, instant final, that is t is equal to 4 second. Put t is equal to 4 here, 4 into 4 plus 4 is equal to 20 radian per second. Angular acceleration. Now, in the class, we have angular acceleration. When a body rotates, when a body is rotating about an axis, which is at a distance of r from the axis, say this is a rod. When it rotates, it will undergo like this about the axis of rotation. This is the distance r. We'll take simplified figure here. The tangent velocity, linear velocity of the particle. If we rotate one double, linear velocity, motion body is rotating like this. Body if we rotate one about the axis, linear velocity will be in this direction, tangential to the particle. It will be, when it is rotating like this, the linear velocity will be tangential to it. Along the direction, see motion in the pakkam irukkirapodu, linear velocity in the pakkam irukkirapodu. That is, therefore, acceleration tangential also in this direction. So, we can say, and there are two types of acceleration, both are linear acceleration. One is acceleration due to centripetal force and acceleration due to tangential velocity. Acceleration due to tangential velocity comes into, for a rotating body, the direction of velocity always changes. Eppadi changes avunga andha arthathula vandha velocity ipdi irukum. See, eppadi linear velocity eppadi kandupidikkiradhu? At this point, draw a tangent to this, that is the direction of the tangency. At this point, this is the direction, since the body is rotating like this, this is the linear velocity and this is the linear velocity if it is rotating like this. If it is rotating like this, it will be the opposite direction. For a rotating body, the direction of velocity is changing, because here the direction is this way, here the direction this way, here this direction. It means the velocity direction is changing. It means velocity's direction is changing. It means there is a change in velocity. What is AT? Final velocity minus initial velocity by time. So, since there is a change in velocity, V minus U is not equal to 0. So, it means it is a definite positive quantity. So, it means A tangential exists. So, A tangential exists only. The tangential acceleration exists. The tangential acceleration when a body rotates exists only when the body is moving with a changing direction. Changing the velocity of the linear velocity of the body has a change in direction, then a tangential exists. Okay. So, another acceleration, a centripetal acceleration, which is given by v square by r. In circular motion, loss of motion, in ac, v square by r, epdi varudhu explain pannirukke, adha paathukke. Now, we will take only the expression. The expression matter eduthukom. AC, rendu velocity is A tangential is equal to rate of change of V tangential. V tangential is equal to D by DT. V is equal to R into omega. Since V, linear velocity is equal to R into omega. So, we can write R value eduthittu D omega by DT, which is equal to r alpha. Rate of change of angular velocity is equal to angular acceleration. Therefore, we can say at is equal to r into alpha. Therefore, at is equal to dv by dt tangential is equal to r into alpha. Now, another one, is centripetal acceleration. When a body is moving in a rotational motion with the uniform speed, when it is moving in the uniform speed, the magnitude of velocity, tangential velocity, is equal to constant. Then only the body will move in a circular path. Speed constant or no, velocity constant or no. every point the velocity, if it is rotating like this, in the adhula, velocity will be like this, be tangential, tangential to the path. So velocity, the velocity is a vector quantity, it changes its direction, therefore there is an acceleration, what we call it as a tangential acceleration. But when the body is moving in rotational motion, due to direction, inertia of direction, if the velocity, tangential velocity is this direction, the particle about the axis, the particle will tend to move like this. Appa in the particle in the circular path la move panna vekkinu enna panna in the edathula there should be a force which called centripetal force. In the edathula pora pola velocity ipdi povo, the particle ipdi pothu try panna adha circular path la pothu, so centripetal force act panna. So centripetal force always acts along the radius towards the center. That centripetal force gives a centripetal acceleration. The centripetal acceleration is equal to linear velocity divided by r. So we can say AC is equal to V square by r. So there are two types of, so it means we can say for this body it has moving along this axis at a distance of r, it will have a tangential direction, it will have an acceleration, and along this one it will have a centripetal acceleration. What is net acceleration? The net acceleration is given by, this is the direction of centripetal acceleration, this is the direction of tangential acceleration. So the resultant is given a net. Both AC and AT are linear acceleration, right? Angular acceleration is represented by alpha. Angular, so AC, when the velocity of the rotating body changes, velocity of the rotating body due to force, if the force is increased, force increase further, and the velocity increase our tangential acceleration also increases. What tangential acceleration? dv square tangential is equal to r into alpha. The net is equal to A, total linear acceleration is equal to, linear acceleration is equal to, see if you take this one, this will be AT 90 degree using Pythagoras theorem, under root AC square plus AT square. This both are linear acceleration. What is acceleration? Linear means moving in one direction. Rotation means having a rotational speed. When the body moves with uniform speed, body moves uniform speed la move pandra podu a tangential is equal to zero, because a tangential exists only when the speed of the rotating body either increases or decreases. Constant ah irukkira podu this is equal to zero. At is equal to zero means what? At is equal to r into alpha is equal to zero. It means r cannot be equal to zero, therefore alpha is equal to zero, where alpha is equal to angular acceleration. So now we talk about the, since tangential acceleration and centripetal acceleration direction is if this is the body, centripetal acceleration is towards this direction, that is from here it goes radially inward, this is centripetal acceleration. And what about the tangential acceleration direction? Tangential acceleration direction will be in this way, depends on if the body is moving like this. And angular acceleration, what is angular acceleration? Angular acceleration is given by rate of change of angular velocity. So angular acceleration is given by rate of change of angular velocity. Since this is also a vector, omega is a vector, and angular acceleration is also a vector, then if it is a vector, what is its direction? Already we have discussed, when a body is moving in a anti-clockwise direction, it is about its axis, the angular velocity will be in the upward direction if it is in the ACW. If it is in clockwise direction, the angular velocity will be downward. Similarly, the angular acceleration direction is along with the angular velocity. So if alpha is up, that is positive, if A omega, angular velocity is positive, that is moving upward. Then alpha is also upward, it is positive. It means alpha will also having in this direction. If the speed of the rotating body slows down, the direction of will be downward. Same way, for the tangential acceleration, this is the tangential acceleration. Body is moving, this is the velocity. Tangential acceleration will be upward when the body is moving with more speed. If it is moving more with speed, the acceleration tangent in this upward direction. If the body slows down and its speed will be in the this way. If the body, it means what? When the body is speeding up, it is having more speed, its acceleration, tangential acceleration is always in the upward direction. If it is in the downward direction, it means the body slows down. If the body is going with the uniform acceleration, tangential acceleration is equal to zero. To summarize all these things, we can see there are two types of acceleration. For a rotating body about an axis, this is the distance r, this is a tangential, and this is a centripetal. So resultant acceleration is equal to resultant of at and ac. It will be somewhere here. This is a resultant. So this will be at. So a resultant is equal to ac square plus at square. At is equal to 0 if the body moves uniform motion. Uniform motion means what? Uniform motion, acceleration is equal to v minus u by t is equal to, for uniform motion, this and this are same, therefore acceleration is equal to 0. That is, a is equal to a tangential. Tangential is equal to d by dt. And tangential is equal to linear velocity and d by dt into r omega, since v is equal to r omega, where r is the this distance and omega is the angular velocity. R d omega by dt and is equal to r into d omega by dt is equal to rate of change of angular velocity is equal to angular acceleration. Now the relation, linear displacement is equal to this distance r into angular displacement. Linear velocity is equal to r into angular velocity. A tangential is equal to r into alpha. So two kind of these, out of this, a tangential and a centripetal. So a tangential, what is a tangential? A c is equal to v square r, a t is equal to r by omega, r linear acceleration, and alpha is equal to angular acceleration, and direction of tangential acceleration is along with the angular velocity. So direction of alpha is always with omega. If tangential component of the acceleration will not exist, if the body is moving with the uniform speed, if the speed is increasing or decreasing, at will exist, that is tangential acceleration will exist. If theta is equal to t cube plus t square plus 1 and r is equal to 2 meter, find angular velocity, angular acceleration, tangential acceleration, linear velocity at t is equal to 2 second. Since is here, what is it? Is it represents instantaneous. Why? Because at t is equal to 2 second is asking, it means at that instant. So it means we are finding instantaneous of all these quantity, and since theta is given, omega is equal to d theta by dt is equal to d by dt into t cube plus t square plus 1, or omega is equal to 3t square plus 2t. At omega is equal to 2 second, it means at t is equal to 2 second, 3 into 2 square plus 2 into 2 is equal to 3 into 4 plus 4, 16, omega, it is radian per second. That means omega at t is equal to 2 second is equal to 16 radian per second. Next, alpha.
alpha is equal to rate of change of angular velocity. Angular velocity, if it means if you are differentiating this one, this is equal to 60 plus 2. So alpha at t is equal to 2 second is equal to 6 into 2 plus 2 is equal to 12, 14 alpha. Alpha is a radian per second square. So alpha is equal to 14 radian per second square. And alpha and a tangential. What is a tangential? A tangential is equal to r into alpha. Okay, so a tangential at t is equal to 2 seconds is equal to r. R is equal to 2 meter into alpha 2 seconds is equal to 14 is equal to 28. So a tangential at alpha t is equal to 0 meter per second square because it is linear acceleration. Then he is asking velocity. What is velocity? Velocity is equal to r into omega. So r is equal to 2, omega t is equal to 16. Omega 16 is equal to 32 meter per second. This is the answer. So we can say a tangential is equal to 28 meter per second square. Velocity linear is equal to 32 meter per second, and alpha angular acceleration in this much, this is omega angular velocity is equal to this much.